Hello everyone, let's do this one last time. Welcome to my channel, it's your boy Tyler on the Fly. And today we're going to talk about one of my favorites. It's about multiverse. It's about Spider-Man into the Spider-Verse. And I'm pretty sure you know the rest of the movie. So, let me tell you about this one. His name is Peter Parker. He got bit by a radioactive spider, and for 10 years, he's been the one and only Spider-Man. So, this is the part he knows the rest, all the rest of the story. So, here's this scene about he was the one and only Spider-Man.
Alright, let's do this one last time. My name is Peter Parker. I was bitten by a radioactive spider. And for 10 years, I've been the one and only Spider-Man. I'm pretty sure you know the rest.
With great power comes great responsibility.
I saved a bunch of people, fell in love, saved the city. And then I saved the city again, and again, and again, and again. And I did this. We don't really talk about this. Look, I'm a comic book. I'm a serial. Did a Christmas album. I have an excellent theme song. And a so-so popsicle. I mean, I've looked worse. But after everything, I still love being Spider-Man. I mean, who wouldn't? So no matter how many hits I take, always find a way to come back. Because the only thing standing between this city and oblivion is me. There's only one Spider-Man. And you're looking at him.
You see, and that is the one and only Spider-Man. Before that, a kid named Miles Morales. But he wasn't the only Spider-Man. Not anymore. Until before, but he was busy with Uncle Aaron, but he saw that spider, and then he bit his hand, and then I was surprised, and then after that, he grown up, and then he thought he has spider powers, and then before he saw Gwen. As like Wanda, I'm like, seriously? And then the sad thing happened. Spider-Man died as Peter Parker, the yellow hair. But before that, he meets the original Spider-Man as Peter B. Parker, as Peter Benjamin Parker. So here's the scene. Of Peter Benjamin Parker.
My name is Peter B. Parker. I was bitten by a radioactive spider, and for the last 22 years, I thought I was the one and only Spider-Man.
What a day.
I'm pretty sure you know the rest. You see, I saved the city, fell in love, I got married, saved the city some more, maybe too much. My marriage got testy, made some dicey money choices, don't invest in a spider-themed restaurant. Then like 15 years passed, blah, 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 super burn, I broke my back, a drone flew into my face, I buried Aunt May, my wife and I split up. But I handled it like a champion. Because you know what, no matter how many times I get hit, I always get back up. And I got a lot of time to reflect and work on myself. Did you know that seahorses, that they mate for life? Could you imagine a seahorse seeing another seahorse and then making it work?
She wanted kids and it scared me.
I'm pretty sure I broke her heart. Flash forward, I'm in my apartment doing push-ups, doing ab crunches, getting strong. When this weird thing happened, and I gotta say, weird things happen to me a lot. But This one's real weird. See, I was in New York, but things were different. Also, I was dead. And blonde. I was kind of perfect. It was like looking in a mirror. I have a feeling that the thing that brought me here was the thing that got him killed. You want to know what happened next? Me too. Who are you?
You see, I cannot believe it's Peter B. Parker. That stands for Benjamin. Peter Benjamin Parker. I just could not believe it. He looks like fat. I was just like, okay. He looks kind of insane, Parker. But he was in a different world, but the things were different. But he thought he was dead. And blonde. He was kind of perfect. It was like looking in a mirror, like different dimension. But he thought that thing it brought him here was the collider got him killed. But Miles meets Peter B. Parker, and then Miles wants to help the other dimension Peter to help him. And then he gets to the collider. Another collider, and then all of a sudden, boom, they want to help. But the funny part is, they went to the burger place, and then he says,
I love this burger, so delicious. One of the best burgers I've ever had in my universe. This place closed 6 years ago.
I was like, okay, that is so funny. I was so funny about this part. and then Miles wants to be like him. And then after that, there's like Dr. Living Octavius. I thought there was supposed to be Otto. Dr. Otto Octavius. But this one's different. A different multiverse, like different dimensions. The reason why is Kingpin wants to get his family back. Just like they did in Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness. Like Scarlet Witch wants to get her boys back. And her wife. I mean, and her, you know what I mean. But that doesn't make any sense. If they want the same thing. Kingpin's parents and Scarlet Witch's boys. That means they're sons. It just came out of nowhere. Let me just skip that for later. But right now, but there's Gwen. Spider-Gwen. I couldn't believe it. So, she's from another dimension. I mean, another dimension. I couldn't believe it. So anyways, here's the scene of Spider-Gwen as Gwen Stacy from another dimension.
All right, people, let's start at the beginning one last time. My name is Gwen Stacy. I was bitten by a radioactive spider. And for the last 2 years, I've been the one and only Spider-Woman. You guys know the rest. I joined a band, saved my dad. I couldn't save my best friend, Peter Parker. So now I save everyone else. And I don't do friends anymore. Just to avoid any distractions. And one day this weird thing happened. And I mean, like, really weird. I was blown into last week. Literally. I landed in New York, but not my New York. My spider sense told me to head to Vision's Academy.
You guys are early.
Wasn't sure why until I met you.
Ooh. I like your haircut.
My name is Peter Parker.
My name is Penny Parker.
My name is Peter Parker.
I was bitten by a radioactive pig.
In my universe, it's 1933, and I'm a private eye. I like to drink egg creams, and I like to fight Nazis. A lot.
I'm from New York in the year 3145. I have a psychic link with a spider who lives inside my father's robot. And we're best friends. Forever.
Sometimes I let matches burn down to my fingertips just to feel something, anything.
I'm a photographer for the Daily Beagle. When I'm not pooching around, I'm working like a dog trying to sniff out the latest story. I frolic and I dance and I do this with my pants and my...
Okay, enough!
You see, I can't deal with their own stories. They don't make any sense, okay? And their own story is... It doesn't make any sense how their own stories begin. Like the robot and the Noir Spider-Man, Peter Parker, like... Seriously? And Peter Parker? Spider-Ham? Seriously? That doesn't make any god sense. Why? It's like different serious dimensions. But this is serious. But now, they just need to find a way home. But it's a good thing they got their home. For now. I just like the original ones. The original ones are better. Instead, the Spider-Pig, the anime with a robot, and Spider-Pig. It is wrong. It is so wrong. Well, the kids like it. Instead of me and my dad. So, it's just so wrong. It is so, so wrong. It is so wrong. So wrong. It's so wrong. So, I just like I said. But they don't have it yet. But they're gonna make a new one. It's called Across the Spider-Verse. So this is for this video. For today. If you haven't seen Spider-Man into the Spider-Verse, make sure you watch it. And watch how the multiverse goes. And this is their own story of their own multiverse, okay? Very simple, okay? So, like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you guys next time. And click the like button. And this is Talent Fly. And this is a scene for you.
I'm Spider-Man.